Kids Health Presents, How the Body Works, with Chloe and the Nerve.
A skiddly bob, a boom, a lot, chaka boom boom, yeah, woo!
Tell me where it hurts.
I'm singing, not hurting. A doo diddly dee!
I do love the drums.
I am drumming in honor of today's quest. To the ear to see how we hear.
So you're playing the drum because we're going to learn how the drum in your ear helps you hear.
That was the plan, but having managed to climb up this tree...
You found that the getting down part is not so easy?
Precisely.
No worries, as the ear is coming here to hear.
Delightful! Before we enter, did you know that there are three parts to the ear?
Three parts? Sing it, Nerb.
The outer ear, the middle ear, and the inner ear. Woo-hoo-hoo!
I'm guessing that this, being on the outside, would be the outer ear.
What a clever Chloe you are! The outer ear, also known as the pinna or auricle. Fancy word! The pinna or outer ear acts like a funnel, collecting sounds to channel them into the ear canal, which is also part of the outer ear.
What are we waiting for? Let's head inside the outer ear. Ooh, what's this gunk on the floor?
You mean this glorious earwax produced by the ear canal?
Nasty earwax is more like it.
Hardly! Earwax contains chemicals to fight off infections that could hurt the skin here in the ear canal, and traps dirt to help keep it clean.
Okay, fighting infection and keeping the ear canal clean is important stuff.
Yeah. Also, earwax will help us slide down the ear canal. Woo-hoo-hoo! Where we find the eardrum! Quietly, my dear Chloe. The eardrum is a very sensitive instrument. Ah, much better. Like my bongo drum, the eardrum is a thin piece of tightly stretched skin.
Do they work the same?
Very much the same, and also different.
Such a nerd thing to say. Explain.
A musical drum makes sound when we hit it. But no one's hitting the drum in your ear. The sound waves that your outer ear collected cause it to vibrate.
Sound waves vibrate the eardrum? Got it. What happens next?
When the eardrum vibrates, it moves a set of three tiny bones on the other side, called ossicles.
Ossicles? That sounds like a drum beat.
Ossicles, ossicles, ossicles. Ossicles.
The three ossicle bones are called the hammer, the anvil, and the stirrup.
Huh. Those bones sort of look like those things. But the sound's journey to the brain isn't over yet, is it?
Not even close. For that, we need to pop past the eardrum to the inner ear.
There are the ossicles.
And there's the cochlea. The ossicle bones connected to the cochlea. The cochlea is a small curled tube filled with liquid. The vibration of the ossicles create waves in the liquid in the cochlea.
Are those little hairs I see?
I'm so happy you asked. The cochlea is lined with tiny hairs. When the fluid in the cochlea moves, it moves the hairs and creates nerve signals that get sent to the brain. The brain understands these nerve signals as sound, and so... You hear.
What?
I said you hear.
Sorry, I can't hear you.
That's because you have earplugs in your ears.
A precaution in case you started singing again.
Ho-ho! What a fine idea. Three parts to the ear you will need if you want to hear. Outer, middle, and inner ear. Scoop, doop, doo-boo. Sound gets funneled in the pinna. Through the ear canal to the middle ear, where the sound makes the eardrum vibrate. Moving the ossicles, 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 ossicles. Mousicles move the liquid in the cochlea. In the inner ear, which move the tiny hairs inside the cochlea. Sending nerve signals to your brain so you can hear. Skiddly doop, 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 I hear you.